So I have renamed all the buttons according to the notes. Now we already have the media file over here, so which came with the template. If you want to add more media file, you can use this upload file option to add media from here. But in order to play the media, we need a player. So we'll add a player now. So the player is in the media and we'll add it here. Now if you see, the player comes outside the phone because it's a non-visible component, and it will just help us play these media sounds. Now let us just go to the coding part. We need something to be something to trigger when we click the command buttons, right? So let's just take an example of the C mode. So when we click on the C mode, what should happen? Okay, so firstly we need to set the source of the player component. So in order to set the source of the player component, we'll use this set player source. So if you can see here, it is over here. So we'll use this. Now what does it need to be set to? So whatever whatever tune or whatever rhythm we want to set, we will use it over here. So we want it to be a C note dot WAV. So we'll have to write in text, and for writing it, we'll use this text block from here like this, and you have to write it in the exact way which is written over here. So capital C, capital N, quote E dot WAV. So C N O T E W A V. So this sets the source of the player. Now we'll have to call the starting of the we have to call the start of the player. So we'll go to this and we'll call player.start. Okay. This we need to do for all our command buttons. So I'll show you one more from here. Either you can do it from here, or another shortcut key is to duplicate this and select a D note from here instead of C note. We'll add a D note here and the rest remains the same. So we'll do it for all the notes, and I'll come back after doing it for all the notes. Alright, so I'm done with all the codes. So now if you see over here, we have all the notes along with the wave files which are changed. Okay, so the C note, D note, E note, F note, and then again there is E note, F note. So if you see that, you can see the cross marks over here. Why? Because the same event is triggered twice. That means I've forgotten to change over here. And whenever you do that, you will see a cross mark, which is an error. So from here, you can just change it to whatever note we want. So we want this one to be A note and this one to be B note. We'll change this to E note and this one to E note. That is how you trigger errors over here. Whenever you see a cross mark anywhere, that means you have triggered the same event twice. Okay, so this code is ready to be tested.